I'm Dr. Danny Vesprini, radiation oncologist at Sunnybrook, assistant professor in the Department of Radiation Oncology at the University of Toronto. I treat prostate cancer and other GU malignancy cancers. Prostate cancer is the most common malignancy diagnosed in men in North America. The two main options of treatment are either a radical prostatectomy with surgery or radiation. So radiation, whether it's external radiation or brachytherapy, all works on the same principle that it's energy. Much like light shines through the cells or goes through cancer cells and then preferentially kills cancer cells, whereas normal cells can repair themselves. Here at Sunnybrook, we treat over 1,000 men a year. It would be probably the biggest radiation prostate facility, and certainly in Toronto, if not Ontario, because we have a large focus. It is an area of expertise and at least excellence at our center. We have 8 radiation oncologists that treat prostate cancer alone. There's 3 main types of radiation that we do here at Sunnybrook, the first being external beam radiation, which is probably the most common. That's where men, which we'll describe, lie down, have external radiation, much like an x-ray. The second is called brachytherapy or internal radiation, where radioactive seeds are inserted permanently inside of the prostate. That's for select men, low-grade disease, low-risk disease. And the third is a combination of external beam radiation therapy as well as temporary brachytherapy or high dose rate brachytherapy, also known as HDR, where the radioactive seeds are temporarily placed into the prostate at certain areas, and that's used in a combination with external beam radiation therapy for very select men with certain features. With external beam radiation therapy, the process entails coming in, having a consultation with the radiation oncologist, being marked up or planned, and that involves having a special CAT scan done where measurements are made, small tattoos are put on the skin for daily localization. A scan is done as long as men have adequate filling of their bladder and a adequate rectum. Some of the things that we're very particular about in regards to planning the radiation. Men have their scans, the tattoos are made permanent. They go home, and then within the next week or two, the radiation oncologist, the radiation therapist and dosimetrist will go over the plan and devise a specific plan based on that person's anatomy, mapping out the prostate, the bladder and the rectum, which are the two main organs that are at risk when we treat men, and then men will typically start about 2 weeks later. Something called a vac lock bag. That's a little apparatus like this, which is just essentially a bag of beans. Where patients are laying there, lay down, their legs and hips are molded around this device. All the air is sucked out, so that allows them to have a very cozy cushion that is to their anatomy, and it just minimizes them from moving around during radiation. Each treatment lasts between about, in the modern era, about 60 seconds. So we have new technology that allows us to get the radiation done very quickly, or traditionally more about 7 or 8 minutes. The radiation plan is devised of 7 different angles around the person's body with the scanner moving around. And each time that beam stops in a certain angle, there can be between 7 and 8 different configurations. Before every single radiation treatment, the scanner will go completely around the patient, provide a small CAT scan, so that if the prostate's more than 2 millimeters away from where it was when we plan the radiation, that adjustments can be made to make sure that we're very precise. This has allowed us to decrease side effects. So men will typically come in Monday to Friday for 8 weeks if they have a prostate and we're treating them for cure, 6.5 weeks if we're treating those men after surgery for whatever reason. We give small doses each day so that a certain percentage of the cancer cells are killed, but in the intervening 24 hours, the normal cells can recuperate to minimize side effects. Once a week, the patient sees the physician, go over the bowel, go over the bladder symptoms, things like that, and ultimately then be followed long term. When we treat men with a combination of external beam radiation therapy and the high dose rate or HDR brachytherapy, the external beam component is the exact same, the same process is undergone. But what men get is an ultrasound on the prostate to map out the prostate. They then come in for the HDR brachytherapy component of treatment, which involves a general anesthetic, so men are put to sleep. catheters are placed inside the prostate, and then a small radioactive seed is inserted along those catheters at certain intervals based on our radiation planning to deliver a very high dose of radiation to that prostate in a single setting. Men are taken out, woken up, make sure they can pee, and they get to go home. In general, the external radiation will start either 2 weeks after that, or in some cases, 2 weeks will start before the brachytherapy, depending on availability of that resource. It's not available in every center. It is slowly becoming more available because it's being found to be a very effective way to treat prostate cancer, specifically those men that are young and have more aggressive disease, so lots of cancer in the prostate. So that is what we select for now. The last option, which is very popular for men with very low-risk disease, is permanent seed brachytherapy, or low dose rate, LDR. That's where the seeds are permanently placed inside the prostate. It involves men coming in, being assessed by ultrasound, having pictures taken essentially, and then a plan is devised based on that person's prostate. They come in a week or two later, the seeds have been since ordered and received. They are then placed inside the prostate at the appropriate areas. CAT scan is done afterwards just to make sure the seeds are where they're supposed to be. And that radiation stays active for several months. Men do need to carry around a little card saying that they're radioactive just in case they go into airports and things like that. But it's a common thing, and the authorities are aware of that. Men are asked to strain their urine for a while because there's a small chance that one of the seeds will fall out, which doesn't pose a risk to anybody, but it is, we take all the precautions necessary. But this is for men with low-grade disease, relatively low PSAs, and men that have prostates that aren't too big. Because if the prostate is too big, then the side effects of treatment go up. Radiation makes people tired because some of our bone marrows are in our hips. The blood is suppressed a little bit during radiation, not enough to cause infections or anything, but it's probably one of the reasons why guys get anemic and a bit tired by the end of radiation. But also coming here every day, Monday to Friday, for weeks is tiring. It's a good, relatively non-invasive way to be treated. It is time-consuming, but in general, short amount of time each day. It avoids surgery in those men that don't want to have the side effects of surgery or are not surgical candidates, and it provides at least what appears to be the exact same chance of living to whatever ripe old age they were supposed to live in the first place. Less than 1 out of 10 men now will need to have a medication because we've been able to keep radiation off of the rectum and off of the bladder. And that's despite the fact that we've increased the dose a lot over the last 10 years as well. There's more sessions, but less side effects. So we, in fact, quote, cure more men, but cause a lot less side effects than we did historically.